If you watch Common Ground online, consider becoming a member or making a donation at lptv.org. Lakeland PBS presents Common Ground, brought to you by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund and the citizens of Minnesota. Production funding of Common Ground is made possible in part by First National Bank Bemidji, continuing their second century of service to the community, a partnership for generations. Member FDIC. Welcome to Common Ground. I'm your host, Scott Knudsen. In this part two of our special season 9 finale, we detail the off-road biking culture in Lakeland's Brainerd viewing area.
The cycling in the Brainerd Lakes, Cuyuna Lakes area has really evolved over the years, and what we have today between all of the recreational trails that exist and our roads, there are so many opportunities. And I think that going forward, we're going to see a continued improvement. We're going to see the cities and counties look more and more at cycling as a way of transportation and as a source of recreation. The Cuyuna Country State Recreation Area's trail system is going to continue to grow. There's trails growing up around it. The Cuyuna Lake State Trail has yet to connect to Brainerd, which is its long-term goal, and to Aiken. So there's room for development along that. So I think going forward, we're going to see a continued growth in cycling in the area. And I think we're also going to see a continued economic growth that surrounds that whole biking activity.
My name is Bruce Father Clunker Swanson. I'm known for riding an old 1949 Montgomery Ward's bike out in the woods that I've turned into a mountain bike. This place where we're standing at is the Cuyuna Pump Track. Several years ago, the city fathers of Cuyuna had some empty land here and they decided, well, what can we do to kind of, you know, build traffic and be fun for people to play on? And it started out, one of the council members, his name was Dan Cruiser, thought, well, maybe if we just pile some dirt up, the kids will ride their bikes on it and play on it.
Well, the city of Cuyuna built a pump track, and it's a cool story. First of all, a pump track is a bicycle track that has several rollers and corners and berms to go around. But the idea on a pump track is once you start riding, to pump your bicycle instead of pedal it and be able to ride around the whole track without pedaling, hence the name pump track.
The origin of pump tracks kind of goes back to the whole BMX scene in the early 70s. And people noticed as the bikes were going up and down rollers, you didn't need to pedal. You could use physics and body motion to get your bike going. What you do on a pump track is you use body English to kind of kick the bike away from you. Then you get to a roller or a bump and you pull the bike up so that you don't waste that energy that you put into the bike. So you kind of pump the bike. And if you're really good at it, and I'm not, but if you're really good at it, you can actually make the bike go around the pump track without more than one or two pedal strokes.
You're pumping your bicycle much like you'd pump a swing. You conserve your momentum. And the city of Cuyuna wanted to build a facility for kids. And now what kind of facility would that be? Well, you know, I suggested a pump track and a reasonably simple one, a few loads of dirt dumped out in the field and we'd shape it and keep the costs down and give a place for kids to ride without a really huge commitment. And there are several other folks that kind of resonated with them, and that project grew bigger and bigger and more refined.
And fast forward a couple years and a guy named Lee McCormick got hired to design a pump track. They learned about how to build a pump track, how to use it, and we're getting to the point now where people are coming from more than just this area. I was talking to a fellow this summer from Cedar Rapids, Iowa that came up here basically just to help me work on the pump track.
So the city of Cuyuna right now has one of the largest pump tracks in the entire country.
The city council basically is the maintenance crew. You look around and you see all the mowing, et cetera, here. That's the mayor. The city council helped move some of this red dirt tailings around. They maintain the campground part of it.
Cuyuna mountain bike crew, we're responsible for the maintenance of the Cuyuna pump track. Assigned the duty as lead dirt man is Bruce Swanson. And Bruce brings to the pump track an amazing amount of analytical skill and enthusiasm both. And so with Bruce leading the charge, there are a number of us that assist him every Tuesday night in maintaining what the city of Cuyuna has created.
And a big piece of the pump track for me and most places in the world, it's about building community. It's about guys get together and ride a little bit. They do what's called slapping dirt and building it, optimizing it, having fun, and just hanging out with each other and having a good time.
In addition to the pump track, the city has also made a campground, and they have a picnic shelter and a playground for kids, so it's become a complete community center. And this pump track takes on a whole nother meaning because the Cuyuna Lakes mountain bike crew is in the process of adding trail from the Cuyuna recreation area to the city of Crosby mountain bike trail that would connect the Cuyuna pump track to the Cuyuna State Recreation Area, plus additional trail in the city of Cuyuna. So with this pump track now, we'll be sitting right in the middle of a whole system of mountain bike trails. So it's really a neat opportunity for families who want to come there, camp, ride the pump track, ride mountain bike trail, catch the Cuyuna Lake State Trail. It makes for a pretty complete cycling experience.
I am Terry Fabian, and I am the trail development manager for the Cuyuna Lakes mountain bike crew.
I became involved just because I was out here riding them every day. It felt like, as a mom of five, it was kind of a bit of a sanctuary, if you will. And that's kind of the way that I would explain or describe this place. It's absolutely beautiful. It's so close, right in basically your very own backyard. Lakes and streams and trees and trails, and it really just couldn't be better. So I became involved because I was out here and I felt a little bit of guilt and was using the trails and decided I needed to do something to give back. And then through meeting all of the people from the climb crew, it really is a family. We call ourselves the Red Dirt Family, and we are.
Well, I've seen people from 7.5 to 75. It's just about people that love to get together and have a good time.
Well, out here at the Cuyuna State Rec area, we have nearly 30 miles now of single track mountain bike trails. So many little mine lakes and streams and rivers if you're out on the back roads.
The term single track refers to a kind of bicycle trail that has room for a single bicycle. Therefore, the name single track. There's one track that one bicycle can fit on. An old road, an old mining road, an old logging road, those would be called two tracks. They were made by two sets of tires and bikes can ride side by side. But the single track is a very specific kind of trail design for mountain bikes. The International Mountain Biking Association has developed a real well-defined set of standards for how a single track should be built in terms of its slope, its angle, the corners, and the whole idea is to build a trail that's fun, safe, and sustainable. The trail system in Cuyuna is constantly evolving. The thing that makes it really unique among other trails is there's been a constant movement toward eliminating all two-way traffic and getting to the point where the entire Cuyuna system is one way. When I say one way, that means all cyclists are going on a trail in the same direction. And that's unusual because in most systems, you have two-way traffic. So what is your uphill is somebody else's downhill. In doing the one-way traffic, what we've been able to do in Cuyuna is, first of all, put a lot more people on the trail and still create a feeling of being out there on a low traffic experience because everyone's going in the same direction. So not only is the experience enhanced, but there's a great increase in safety as well.
Well, Oremageddon is our biggest race event of the year. It happens the first weekend in October. This year it brought in about 350 riders. We had riders from Canada, we had riders from Alaska. This year it was sponsored by Teravail. We had Surly Brewing there.
Oremageddon has become a real major player in the mountain bike racing scene within Minnesota. The Cuyuna single track is well known as being extremely well designed, and as a result, it's also a very fun course to race on. The Oremageddon then brings some of Minnesota's top cross-country biking racers and compete against one another.
A race like Oremageddon or the Whiteout in the wintertime, or there's a mountain bike series race in the summer, is all about the competition. Cyclists bring their bicycles, they compete with each other in the race. There's camaraderie during the race. And then when the race is over, they pack up their stuff, maybe go and, you know, spend a little community time with each other and leave.
When you're at Oremageddon, what you'll find are a group of cyclists who have come to Cuyuna for one purpose, a cross-country bicycle race.
Well, from start to finish, they start Friday night if they come out to the pre-race registration party. This year we had it out at Rutgers. It was back on the lake. It was absolutely stunningly beautiful. The leaves were changing. They had a young gal out there playing the ukulele with an amazing amount of talent. Everybody was kind of a little awestruck, actually. She was a super talented girl. And they served food. Surly Brewing was out there again. Our partner Freewheel was out there with their mobile unit selling merchandise, and bonfires and s'mores were going, and it was just an all-around amazing place to just kind of come out and hang out and spend some time before the race the next morning. Race morning, well, this year it was a nice, foggy, beautiful morning. There's a lot of anticipation, it always seems like, in the air. A lot of people kind of milling about, eating, placing all their packs and their water bottles. The 300 and some odd racers all lined up at the starting gate.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
The start of the race immediately went up Miner's Mountain. Miner's Mountain is a very long, tough climb. But something like that right in the beginning of a race really separates the field out. And once you hit the single track, it's hard to pass because, again, it's only got enough room for one cyclist at a time. So anything that can be done prior to that to sort the field out and get the fastest people up front and the people who aren't quite as fast behind them is very important. And there's nothing that will sort a group out quicker than Miner's Mountain.
Well, they could choose from three different lengths of race. So the 50 mile, the 25 mile, or the 12 mile. We call it the hot lap. I think we had 5 total waves this year. Everybody started out and climbed nearly to the top of Miner's Mountain Road, where then they jumped on the single track, grabbed a piece of bacon if they wanted it, and headed on down to basically start the course from the other side. Then, depending on their race, they rode either 12, 25, or 50 miles. The 50 milers did actually 2 laps of nearly all of the single track here at the Cuyuna Lakes rec area.
Racing on a single track is one step up from riding on a single track. By one step up, I mean, at this point, you're going as fast as you can go. You're going at your limit, and at a limit that you can sustain for the entire length of the race, which could be up to 50 miles. When racing on a single track, you try to get out as quick as you can at a pace you hope you can maintain, and then throughout the race, hold that position or improve it. If one starts off too slow, then you have such difficulty passing people that you're at a disadvantage for the whole event, And on the other hand, if you get out ahead of people that are faster than you, then you spend a fair amount of energy allowing them to get by. And so it just works better as a strategy to go out hard, but go out at a pace where you feel you can maintain this pace throughout the race. When racing on a single track, you'll have one bike right in front of you and they're going as hard as they can go. You're going as hard as you can go, trying to stay with them or looking for an opportunity to pass. There very well could be someone right behind you trying to stay with you or looking for an opportunity to pass.
I'm gonna go to my left up here, you go to my right.
Good job. So you've got the dynamics of the other racers and the dynamics of the course itself. So as you're doing this at 100% effort, you have to be watching for opportunities to pass, opportunities to increase your speed, but always trying to stay on the bike.
You okay, man?
Yep.
Do you need EMT or anything?
No, I'm okay.
You all right?
Yeah.
Let me know if you require assistance.
No. Thank you.
You need help with it?
Is that a skirt? No, not quite.
Now it's a little bit too far. There you go, man.
Cuyuna was never designed for racers only. Cuyuna was designed for a mountain biking experience. And ideally, mountain bikers that possess a wide variety of abilities. So you can gain challenge on the Cuyuna trails by just going faster. The Cuyuna single track has designed into it a really, really neat concept, and that is the challenge of the trails is determined by how fast you ride. So if you go slow and take your time, the trails are quite rideable for everyone.
New stuff here.
As you go faster, all of a sudden the corners become sharper, or they feel like they're sharper. The hill becomes a little more challenging because you're trying to go up it faster. There might be two rollers in the trail. For the slower rider, they ride over both rollers. For someone with enough speed, they go off the front side of the front one and land on the back side of the second one. So the trail is designed that you add challenge by virtue of your speed, not by the difficulty of the terrain itself. As you're riding the trails, there's a certain sense of speed that you get just by nature of the trees whipping by. They're so close to your handlebars. And there's so many different things that you need to keep track of, yet if you again slow down just a little bit, then that disappears.
Well, the trails can be anything from sharp, punchy little climbs, rocky and rooty, to nice, smooth, sandy, flowy trails. We have some really nice trails over on the rally side that are windy, so people get to experience going through trees and tight cornering, and then of course the amazing downhills that everybody is so fond of up on bobsled and Sandhog Mountain with the big sandy berms.
On the Cuyuna trail system, there's only two races in an entire season. Most of the riding are recreational people who either from the area or drive from other areas, but they come there to ride the trails, ride at their own pace, and create their own experience. A lot of the trails use a construction method called a bench cut, where the trail is cut into the side of the hill and it traverses along the hill. So as you're riding these bench cuts on the uphill side, you'll have a slope that comes up to your side, but on the off slope side, you'll have a drop off. And these drop offs can be gentle and they can be rather steep. And in Cuyuna, we have both. In all cases, you still have a wide area to ride on, maybe up to 3 feet. In some cases, as wide as 4. Other places, it may be down to 24 inches. It's safe, but it can give the feeling of not being safe. So I kind of look at it as feeling like you might be in danger and you aren't.
I guess the experience is to feel like you're 10 years old again. That's really, for me, what the root of it all comes down to. You put forth effort, you know, you climb the hills and then you go on the downhill and you feel like you're 10 years old. And so it keeps you young, it keeps you happy.
Mountain biking really has no age barriers. And so in Cuyuna, we see all ages and genders. One of the things that's really, really a nice thing to see in our area is the Cuyuna Lakes High School mountain bike team and Coach Sean.
How you doing?
I'm Sean Anderson, head coach for the Cuyuna High School mountain bike team. This is Mari Cavisto, my assistant coach. The high school mountain biking team is new to Minnesota 6 years ago. Aaron Houdala came to us about 5 years ago and said, hey, I've got a great idea. We have a really great set of trails and we would like you guys to start a team up here, being that you have kids that ride. So at first we just went, yeah, we like to ride bike with kids, didn't really think much about it or where it was gonna go, and took a step to get the team started.
It's exploded since then. I think we almost doubled our participant count from last year. We're up at 49 riders. We have anywhere from 15 to 20 ride leaders who are adults that help us.
What is a typical day for a student on the mountain bike team?
Well, they go to school and then they show up here. They get their bike ready. They get inflated. They get hip, what we call it, hydrated, inflated, protected with their helmets, and then they get in groups and we split them up by their ability level. And then our ride leaders also break into those groups and take them off into the trails. Some days it's easier, some days it's harder, and it's all structured to ensure they have peak performance by the end of the season.
Well, the team policy that we're getting at is no child doesn't play. Everybody participates. Everybody contributes to a team score. Everybody contributes to the team spirit, and we really, really focus on inclusivity with everybody, that this is a place where they can go and have fun and be treated fair and respectful and get something out of it. It's been really life-changing for a lot of families that have been involved with us.
All right, everybody else, send these rock stars out as they go on their adventure.
There's a fair amount of diversity out on the trails. Men, women, kids. I could say everyone out there is a kid in some way, but nonetheless, there's a lot of diversity. So it's not a guy's sport or a woman's sport or just for kids. It really is for everyone, and we see that. So on the trail, you'll see everyone from a teenager who's on the high school mountain bike team to somebody who's in their 60s or 70s, and everybody's doing the same thing. They're riding their mountain bike and having a really good time.
I'd like just to see more women out here. We've got some ladies out here that are older, that are so inspiring, and you just meet these women and they're just happy and healthy, and it just makes you realize that you probably do have quite a few more years than you actually do.
The trails have invited and they've encouraged a lot of people to come to the area that maybe didn't have a route here, or maybe renewed their roots here. They ride their bikes on the hills, they ride their bike on the trails. They maybe visit grandma, they maybe bring their friends, and then they hang around town and they have a hamburger or they have a beer or whatever suits their fancy. And maybe the next day they're gonna windsurf on one of the lakes or do something else. But it gets people off the couch, gets them up out having a good time, enjoying Mother Nature in ways that maybe they didn't expect a few years ago.
For myself and my family, we have just recently made a move down here because of the trails and the recreation. It's so beautiful and there's so many things to do. So I think it's bringing new people to the area. It's bringing new businesses to the area. It's kind of bringing a new fire and a new energy that this area needs.
It also gives residents a reason to be connected. So I can go into town and we can talk bikes, where before we may not have had a reason to say, hi, how are you doing? It also gives us a reason to spend our time together. So if we're volunteering or, you know, collaborating on new projects, they're centered a lot around this area, and it gives us a place to put our passions.
The mountain bike trails were developed in Cuyuna, and the thing that has become real obvious is this was something that people enjoyed. And I say the obvious because the huge number of users that come to Cuyuna. And so that original trail system that was built in 2010, opened in 2011, has been expanded a few times, and there's two more expansions that are in the process of development. So the Cuyuna State Recreation Area, as a mountain bike destination, has come totally into reality.
Thank you so much for watching. Join us again next season on Common Ground. If you have an idea for Common Ground in North Central Minnesota, email us at legacy@lptv.org or call 218-333-3014. To watch Common Ground online, visit lptv.org and click local shows. Episodes or segments of Common Ground, call 218-333-3020. Production funding of Common Ground was made possible in part by First National Bank Bemidji, continuing their second century of service to the community, a partnership for generations, member FDIC. Common Ground is brought to you by the Minnesota Arts and Cultural Heritage Fund, with money by the vote of the people, November 4th, 2008.